Start off your afternoons with Ashton and Selo as they calm your nerves and shine a light into your life. This is the afternoon show with Ashton and Selo.
Thanks for tuning in here to the afternoon show. Ashton and I will be discussing the power of music today, as well as Ashton's music spotlight and some uplifting prank calls, all that and more when we return. Stick around. We have a great episode for you coming up after this song, and this is a powerful song, so really listen. This is Directions featuring Joseph by Nako and Medicine for the People.
For the worst, for the north, for the east, for the south, come from there, I'm calling on you, need your guidance now.
That was Directions featuring Joseph by Nako and Medicine for the People. You are amazing and beautiful, everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in and sticking with us. My name is Selim, and I am very honored to be here with you, along with the amazing Ashton Robertson. Hello, Ashton.
Hello.
Thanks for being with us, as always.
Of course. Honored to be here.
So let's talk about the power of music. Music can be found in every known culture, past and present. Every religion talks about how life began as a word or a sound. And there's just so much that can be said about this topic, the power of music. And I know, Ashton, you're pretty passionate about this specific one. So let me ask you this. What makes music so powerful?
Oh, man, I think the biggest thing is that not only does it like help people, you know, relate, having a relatable, you know, song lyrics that really touch someone's heart, or, you know, the feeling of the music opens someone's heart, but like, I think on a collective level, music puts everyone in the room on the same wavelength. So anyone that's listening to the same song is on the same wavelength as everyone else that's listening to it. And so like our differences are put aside. So like you'll go to a concert and there'll be people dancing and being together who like weren't even like civil in a room before. But because there's music there, it allows people to be in the same wavelength, and it really kind of, you know, like nullifies our differences. Mm-hmm.
Definitely. Music can bring a whole lot of people together. And I often hear and say myself that music is like, it's like the universal language, because even people who don't speak the same language, who can't communicate, they can play music together and, you know, kind of communicate that way. So I think music is amazing for bringing people together, for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. In so many different ways. You know, like when I'm at a music festival, I can really notice, because, you know, maybe not everyone is at stage listening to the music, but there's a bunch of people there, you know, selling their stuff or just hanging out. But the music is what brought it together. It's like the glue. Even if someone doesn't like the music, it's like the music is the glue that holds it all together.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And kind of getting back to what I said earlier, when a lot of people in religion and otherwise talk about how creation, how everything began as a sound, as a sound wave. So with that in mind, thinking about it, music can create amazing things. The sound vibration can do so many, 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 many magical things. And I don't think people realize how important music can be to the world. We just did a drum circle last night at Phoenix Landing Wellness. And, you know, it was a lot of kind of different people from different walks of life. And it was just really special being able to have everybody come together and being able to express ourselves through music. I think people can get a lot of emotion out through music that they normally wouldn't through language. Have you noticed that at all, Ashton?
Oh, absolutely. You know, it like transcends the mind. You know, it's not a normal thought form, even though it's a way of communicating. But, you know, even just for me, you know, the way music can, you know, like change my mood or like make me keep going. And, you know, music's like the one thing that's always there. And mm-hmm. Yeah, it really helps us transcend our emotions and brings things up.
Mm-hmm. And I know you've been creating music since you were, from what I know, at least in high school, and so it's been a big, big part of your life. So, well, how do you feel when creating music? Because I mentioned earlier that a lot of people express themselves through music, but What is the creation process like? What's going through your emotions? What kind of energy do you feel while creating music?
I guess it varies. You know, it's very empowering, and being able to like put my energy into something, like you can channel whatever energy into music. So like for my passion for like just trying to, you know, like expand consciousness and all of that stuff. Mm-hmm. Music is really a gateway for me to like bridge that gap, you know, in ways that I couldn't otherwise. And just for myself, it's like, it's a process, you know. It's some days are up, some days are down, and you have to like learn how to like work through what your mind is saying and just, you know, keep going. And, you know, it changes who you are, I think, for sure.
Mm-hmm. So in some of your songs, I know other people, a lot of people actually use what are known as solfeggio frequencies. And I think this is something that I don't know a whole lot about, but I know that these can be very powerful sound waves. What is your understanding of solfeggio frequency?
Well, it's a few specific frequencies that are said to like create healing and potentially like awaken like your intuition, get you more in touch, I think, with your own spirit, essentially, is what anything's doing to like. So the solfeggio frequencies, just in general, I think like vibrations either are like, they like create geometry and they create like an environment. So these specific frequencies have like a very beautiful healing geometry that's created, and it's like they're like in tune with the patterns of nature, like mathematically. So you know, the theory is that they're like creation frequencies, and like can like they like create realities and stuff.
Yeah, I while you're talking, it reminded me of, I think his name is Dr. Emoto or something like that, but he did this experiment with water where he had people in front of it saying really nice things to the water, and then he would freeze it and look at the structure of that water, and when people were nice to it, they said, you know, like, I love you, you're beautiful. It created, like you said, this beautiful sacred geometry. But when people were saying bad things, it just kind of looked like a blob. So,
like, a blob. Right, like if all the music we were listening to was like all like, you know, super hateful, like it was like, I wish you would die and all your friends will die. And like if that was like every song you heard, then like no one would like music.
Exactly.
It's just, you know, like people like people need uplifting things. And that's like, I think the real power of music is like when you intentionally try to uplift people through your music, it like, or if you like have a powerful experience and you put that into your music, mm-hmm. and then it puts that like state of consciousness, it like solidifies it, and then people can tap into it.
Mm. And definitely, like the music can alter your vibration. It can alter your atoms and kind of how you feel about yourself. And just, I'd say, listen to uplifting music. It's actually why we're here. Bring Me Life Radio got started because we wanted to put out that uplifting music. So we definitely believe in the power of uplifting music. And so I think with that, maybe it would be a great time to get into the next segment, Ashton. I know you might have a song for us here today.
Yeah. When you asked about this, it like came right to my mind that it should be a Kalia Scintilla song for today's topic of like power of music, because his music is, first of all, in 432 hertz, which is an alternative tuning, which, you know, I don't think is necessarily better or worse, but just the intention is there so that it's like more healing. And I think that shift alone is like worth the try, the effort. But like his music, I think, is so powerful because it's a lot of like heavy bass, like modern day bass music or electronic music. But it also has like beautiful melodies and like well written out like world instruments, like violins. And there's like this cinematic nature to it. And I think the combination of the heavy hitting bass with like the beautiful emotion over top of it is really like this full spectrum like experience. And yeah. Light of the North by Kalia Scintilla.
Thank you.
right. There you have it, Light of the North by Kalia Scintilla. Thank you, Ashton, for bringing this to our attention.
Absolutely. I love listening to it, too.
Definitely. So, do you have any final thoughts before we move on to the uplifting prank calls?
I just want to, like, personally thank, like, music itself. I don't know if it can hear me or whatever, but, like, just music, thank you so much. Like, I don't know if I could have even made it this far in my life without you. And it just, you know, makes it all worth it. Even if I didn't make music, like, music is just the best. And it's, like, saving lives and bringing us all together.
Definitely. It is bringing us all together, and it is so beautiful and so wonderful. And, you know, I think people come from other parts of the universe to experience what it's like to have music on Earth, because it's so powerful, so unique.
Seriously. it's like our human gift.
Yeah. One of the blessings as a human, you get to,
like, artists, like, music is art, I think, you know.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. All right. Well, I guess this will be a great time now. We're going to move on to our next segment, which is called the Uplifting Prank Calls. So thank you, everybody, and enjoy.
Uplifting Prank Calls.
Grand Soul Burger King.
Hi there. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. I just wanted to call and say that I hope you have a ridiculously amazing day today.
Oh, well, thank you.
You're
welcome. Hope you do as well.
Oh, thanks. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you for calling Sister Fibrosis Foundation. How can I help you?
Hi, who is this? I'm just kind of tell you that you should be doing more of what gives you joy. I know this might sound weird, but I'm just, like, the universe kind of tell you that you should celebrate and have fun, and you don't need to suffer to grow. In fact, true happiness comes from following the dictates of your soul. Take steps today to expand your joy, and you don't need to do it all at once, but you do need to start. And I just want to let you know that you're supported and loved, and I'm just, like, a bird passing by, and I love you, and I hope you have the best day ever.
Okay, thank you. Same to you.
Absolutely.
Bye-bye.
Okay. Here's how may I help you.
Hi there. How are you doing today?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you for asking. I just wanted to call and wish you good health and happiness, and thank you for being a part of this world. I hope you have a great day today.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Uplifting Prank Calls.
And there you have it. Uplifting Prank Calls.
Epic.
It's always nice to do that, and it's just kind of fun to have people be like, oh, well, thank you so much. You too.
Yeah, that's like, I want someone to prank phone call me.
Me too. That'd be great. It'd be like the best day ever.
Right? I'm like, it'd be so good. You're like, who, why? Why did that happen? Who did that? God.
Perfect. So if anybody listening would like us to prank call some of your friends or family members, just send us a message, comment wherever you're listening, and let us know, and we'll get back to you and make sure we do that. So thanks, everybody. any final comments for the episode, Ashton?
I just want to thank everyone for tuning in, and I'm sending my love out to the Multiverse and everyone on Earth.
Awesome. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in here to the afternoon show. We are recording live Thursdays at 12 p.m. Eastern Time on Bring Me Life Radio, and you can always listen to us on iTunes and YouTube, and hopefully soon iHeartRadio. So thanks, everybody. We're going to end today's episode with a song by Halation. It's called Evolve, and it's something that got sent in by Wake Magazine. So thank you, Wake Magazine. Have a great day, everybody. Thanks again.